Record on this computer and we're on. All right, team, welcome. Welcome to Quick Fixx. I'm coming into the screen here in just a second. I'm going to push that forward. There we go. Welcome to Quick Fixx. Oh, this camera's too close. My name is Heather. Hi, Sharon. Hi, Melanie. Welcome, friends. Dumbbells, Matt, and something to drink if you need it. We have a warm-up, and then once we get through the warm-up or during the warm-up, I'll explain a little bit more how the workout's going to go today. We got a lot of repeated stuff, so that always makes it beneficial to your body, your mind. You can kind of release and just have some fun. Go as heavy or as light as you need on this Monday. I hope you guys had a great weekend. Oh my gosh, I don't know why that camera's there. I might have to adjust it. Let's find first things first. Let's find a squat stance. Put your feet in your squat position. Ready, set. Let's have a seat. Feet are about hip to shoulder width distance apart. Weight is in the heels. Your toes, knees, and hips all need to line up. So if you end up taking a wider step or you turn the toes out, maybe that works better for your knees or your back. Please adjust so that we've got alignment first. Always go for alignment and then we go for intensity. What does intensity mean for you today? Well, for those of us in-house, probably not as intense as some people might take at home, and that's okay. We're gonna do our very best for the workout. This is Quick Fixx, so take it as intense as you're willing to go. Welcome aboard, Lori. I got that record button hit for you. We're gonna keep the warm-up basic. I haven't seen your face in weeks. Once we get through the warm-up, we'll go through that first round of movements kind of in a warm-up fashion. Let's make a change alternating lunges. Right side to left side. Feet remain hip or a little wider than hip distance to help you balance. I forgot my little plastic thingy. So when you don't keep the feet under the hips, we start to tightrope, which makes lunges way more challenging, first of all, but also ineffective and dangerous. The back heel is lifted. Once you get your alignment, focus on weight being in the front foot. Pushing through the floor. As you rise up, actively warming up our glutes, hamstrings, and quads. We have squats today, we have lunges, we have burpees. I already gave away that secret. Next transition in just a few seconds is our inchworm. When you're ready, feet are under the hips, hinging at the hips. Keep the legs as straight as possible. Walk out to a high plank. Hold it for a split second if you would like. Perform a push-up, knees or toes. Walk back in, stand up, repeat. Now you're on my clock, palms are flat, stacked up underneath the elbows, wrists, and shoulders. You keep in motion. I forgot my turtle shell. I also want to see if I can. Yeah. Secret sauce right there, I found the button. We have about 10 more seconds here in this warm-up move. And then we're going to do a shorter version, repeat the movements. 4, 3, 2. When you're ready, stand up. Let's repeat. Might as well get used to that. Repeat. Repetition equals recognition. You're going to get smoother at the movements. You can take the movements and make them more challenging at any time. If you didn't come here for challenging, that's okay. You can take it easy with me today. Less than 10, we transition to alternating lunges. 3, 2, change here. If you need or would like, you can start to add a forward stepping lunge. I have reverse and forward today. If you say I cannot do forward lunges, that's bothersome to my knees, you'll stick with the reverse option and still get a great workout. Remember, the alignment we practice right here, right now, will benefit us in about 20 minutes, 25 when we're all done. 4, 3, finish on each side. 2, Last set of inchworms. See if you can pick up your pace. Keeping everything stacked, muscles engaged, core is tight. Lengthen the hamstrings as best you can in set two. Our workout dead ahead has 7 movements in it today. 7, don't worry. I've got them written down. They're 40 seconds of work, 20 seconds we rest. Between each round, we get 1 minute. Last 3, 2, and time. So 4-0 we work, 20 you recover. You can always redo. We're gonna try to get through this 5 times. We probably won't, right? Just based on the clock. Whatever, we'll do our best. 3 to 5 times. Successfully, we start with squats. You choose the variation. You can do body weight. You can hold 1 dumbbell as a goblet. You can hold 2 dumbbells as a front squat. Don't worry, you can always transition to a different type of squat another round. From there, I'm just gonna get you ready for what's next. So have your equipment nearby. Who's ready? I'm ready. Squat position. I'm taking round 1 body weight. You can do whatever kind of squat you like today. Ready, set? Let's go. 40 seconds of work. Now I don't need you going slow and steady if you can, depending on what you're holding for weight, if any. Find work now. Now we find work. I keep standing right in front of you. I'm so sorry. These squares, we should have balanced them. Weight is in the heels. Sit your hips as low as your body will go. It's going to be different for everybody. You're halfway. Just 15 seconds left here. Five more seconds. 4, 3, 2, change. Grab a mat so you can kneel and a set of light to medium dumbbells. Biceps curls. Kneeling position. You can stand if you would like. Get the toes in kickstand formation. Squeeze your butt tight. Dumbbells come together. Here we go, 40 seconds, short range of motion curls. Now to adjust this, what could you do? You could alternate here, giving your biceps some relief. This type of curl is a really isolated curl. Biceps are gonna get pulled up. If you're like, I went really light here, Heather, I could have gone heavier. You could do that in set two. The belly button, draw it towards the spine. Hips are nice and tight here, so we're engaged. We're locked in with our body. 5 seconds. 3, 2, and 1. I forgot I have dumbbell snatches in here, which we did not review. Don't worry, I'll help you. Grab a light to medium-ish weight. You're gonna alternate these. Here's what they look like. Deep squat, neutral spine. Punch it up, set it down. Switch. I'll walk you through every one of them for this first set. And then I'll give you a nice alternative. Ready? Set. Let's go. Sit down. Draw the dumbbell close to your body. Chin is out of the chest. Stand it up. This is a power move. So we just did 2 really great strength moves. Adding in some power. We'll go back to strength after this. We're already halfway. Nice work. Those look good, Joanna. You're gonna draw the dumbbell up like washboard on the tummy. We're using explosive move to get under the dumbbell. We call it almost a violent move in the Olympic world. Time. 1 dumbbell. Dumbbell thruster. If you've been in my class, you've done this before. Right leg will stay, don't go yet. Dumbbell front wrap. You will lunge. Press, lunge, press. Get ready. Right foot planted, left arm holds. 2, 1, let's go. Lunge back, press. If you can, go forward, press. Trying to keep our hips square now with our unstable stance and a front to overhead load should be a challenge. If it's not, we go heavier on the next set. Do You have 10 seconds. We have to switch sides, not until we rest. 3, 2, and 1. Set your weight down nearby. Get ready for the next set, side 2. You have 10 seconds. How's the heart rate doing? It's up, right? Good. All right, 5 seconds. Pick up your weight. Front rack, get ready. 2, 1, step back, overhead. Excellent. A lot of repetition per 40 seconds. Truth be told, if you wrote this on paper and I gave it to one of my coworkers, I'd probably put something like 3 to 5 sets, 10 to 15 reps. That's all we're doing. Just a lot of exercises of it. Full body workout, taking our conditioning with us. You have 10 more seconds here. And then things are gonna get spicy. 3, 2, time. Quick options, burpees, option 1. Option 2, I guess that would technically be option 3. Burpee push-up. No bellies down. Big jump for higher intensity. Get ready. 2, 1, let's go. Drop into a push-up. Jump high, and if you say, I don't have that in me, then you just hop out into a high plank. Hop in. Add a jump if you can. Push-ups add a lot of strength component. We're over halfway. That's good news. We have 1 movement left, and we'll be done with round 1. Four, 3, 2, time. Oh. Yep, with a mask, it's even better. Plank position. You're gonna hear me cue a few things in a plank. You don't have to do a plank. We're doing core work here. So feel free to mix it up. I assure you we're gonna mix it up because I get bored. That's how I roll. Get ready. It's coming quick. Forearm plank to start. Ready, set. Lift it up, hold. So toes on the ground, elbows under the shoulders. Your gaze is on the floor between the hands. Now let's think about our body. Shoulders push away. You're pushing your chest away from the floor. Your belly button is drawn to the spine. And if you can, lock in the thighs and the butt. This first one will just hold. Try to draw as if you're drawing your elbows toward your toes. Yeah. 6 seconds. We get an official break. It's 1:20 total. 3, 2, time. There you go, there's round 1. We gotta do that a couple more times, whatever the clock allows. Probably 3 more, I'm not gonna lie, I'm gonna keep you a little late. You already knew that. Grab a sip, you'll need it. Grab different weights if you can, if you need. Yeah, we're having fun in here. I wish you were all with us. I mean, you are. But here, so I know personally I can go a little bit more, so I have weight options in this studio, which is kind of nice. You have 35 seconds. When you're on recovery, don't waste the time. Here's what I like to do. Inhale through the nose, open mouth. It really helps you recover more efficiently. So we're gonna hit set 2, same exact lineup. Make adjustments where you need, when you want. Always is your workout, you guys. You've got 12 seconds on my stopwatch. We start with squats. You can mix it up and add weight. Range of motion changes. Gear up. 4, 3, 2. Let's go. Round 2. What do you got in you today? Don't feel like it's pressure to make this big performance right now. Rather, step into each 40 seconds. Not overthinking it, not assuming anything, just do it. And then if your body says nope, move a different route and adjust. I want your heart rate, especially if you're home, to start to spike for me. You've only got it for 40 seconds. Six to go. Three, two, time. Woo, kneeling, biceps curls. I almost said kneeling squats. I mean, we could try that. We'll just create some things in here. 10 seconds. Not five. Get yourself situated on the knees. Lock in. Let's go. Dumbbells together. Really good posture right now. We're not leaning back. We're not working the quads and the lumbar. Just squeeze the butt, but lift the crown of the head up toward the sky. Good control. You've got 15. Now 10. We have that alternating snatch dead ahead. Great power move, great shoulder move, core, hips. Three, two, time. Clear your space. Grab a dumbbell for snatches. Six seconds, you guys. Get ready. Big wide stance. Neutral spine. Ready, set. Let's go. Little quarter bend in the hips and the knees. Little tiny squat measure. So everything explodes. Triple hip extension, ankle and knee. Dumbbell lands directly over the shoulder. Straight arm. Biceps is by the ear. We have 10 more seconds. Just getting your heart rate in motion. Now, if you've got a really heavy dumbbell, this is taking your breath away. Three, two, time. Here comes the lunge thruster. So remember, dumbbell's gonna go in the left hand. Right leg will stay stable. Isolated. Pick up your weight, 5 seconds. Three, two, here we go. Step back, lunge, press. This is where your feet hip to shoulder width distance matters. It's gonna help you balance. This is another one if you have heavy enough weight overhead. Your stability is really challenged. It's great for the core. It's great for the lateral hips even. Although we're not really in lateral training today. 10 more seconds. Four, three, two, time. Same thing side, two. My favorite part of when you're working out, you get done with one side challenge, you're like, oh no, I gotta balance you. All right, pick up your weight, 5 seconds. Three, two, let's roll. You might get even really gifted in the next couple sets, forgot to mention. Counting. Trying to match whatever you get from side one on side two. It's good to train in balance, meaning if you always train just squats, your lunges, you might notice one glute is weaker than the other, or inner thigh. That's why we like to bring you new challenging moves. 10 seconds. Four, three, two, time. Uh-oh, burpees. I put him second to the last because it's like, oh, I'm done, but then you have a plank. 10 seconds, take your breath, inhale, push it up. Any burpee will do. Five, three, two, go. Make sure you jump a little higher. Get your chin out of your chest when you come up off the ground. You can reach 6+ inches above you. That'll just add some intensity if you want it. Never required. You don't ever have to jump. 10 seconds left. All we have is a plank and recovery. 3, 2. Get your mat if you need it. Nice job, Joanna. Let me go distract everybody's brain a little bit. 10. We'll start in a forearm plank. 3, 2. Let's lift here. Now you know what to do to lock in, right? Let's take a walk the plank. Right hand goes flat left, full push-up position. Drop those elbows back. Alternate which hand you come up with. This is just an alternative to engage our brain a little bit. Halfway. You get recovery on the other side. Last 10. Three, two, time. Yeah, yeah. Grab a sip. Could we do two more? I think we can. That puts us halfway. And if you have to go, you know the rules. You can leave. I don't mean that disrespectful. I just mean if you need to go and I'm keeping you. We're going to do it two more times because I say why not? When you're in it, you might as well school it. After this, you have time for stretching. Catch your breath. Make sure you sip water between these rounds, okay? It's your gasoline for the rest of class. Seconds. Same exact setup. That's always good news in my head because I'm like, there's a couple moves. I'm like, oh, I got them. I even cheat and use them as recovery. So take that as your strategy. If squats help you recover and just like, I can just flow through those. If it's the curls, I'm okay with that. If you want just push-ups and you're like, I'm done with your burpees, remember I always say write your own notes. So just a rule in my class. Stand it up for squats. It's coming, round 3. On my mark, 4, 3, 2, go. You could add squat jumps to intensify it. Obviously, dumbbells is gonna add that resistance feature. Resistance is anything you use with gravity, right? So that we have to activate our hips to stand up, get the quads involved. The lower you get the hips, the more glute we get. Never required, you can't go that low. You have 10 seconds here, team. No big deal, right? Yeah. 4, 3, 2, time. Biceps. Kneeling biceps. What I like about this format is it just kind of slowly ascends your heart rate. Every move. Kneeling if you can, get your weights out. Ready, set, let's go. Also, if you run a clock, like we're doing today, it's gonna force you just to keep in motion. So when fight or flight shows up in your head, and it will, instead of stopping, you're like, oh, but the notes say, the clock says, crown of the head, draw it up. Exhale. Even in the strength movements, as simple as they feel, don't lose ground on keeping the heart rate moving. 6 seconds. 3, 2, time. Snatches. We're gonna alternate them. Heart rate should come up here. 4, 3, 2, let's go. Nice job, good control. Always looking to be in control of your weight. This is not the place anyways in my world, I want you out of control. have a little fun, especially if the movement is newer. Look at us learning a new move. And if you're like, I didn't know I could bring my heart rate up doing this movement for just 40 seconds, now you know. 5 more seconds. 3, 2, time. Lunge thruster. Moderate to heavy. One side at a time. In 10. At the 5, I'll tell you to pick up your dumbbell. Here it is. Front racket. 3, 2, let's go. Watching your alignment now, especially as we hit points of fatigue. 15 seconds to go on this side. Last 10. Three, two, time. Yeah. I get excited because I can see the light now. I'm like, we have one round after this. That's it. So be in the work, pick up your weight. It's okay to be uncomfortable, that's what we're here for. Ready, let's go. It's just 40 seconds. If you put that in the light of perspective, it's not much time. It feels like a lot of time when you're under load. You rest, recover, and return anytime. How are we doing at home? Yeah, everybody! Bless the Tom! Thrusters always bring your heart rate up. Time. Burpees. And the crowd roars. That room. The higher you jump, the higher your heart rate comes. Get the chin out of the chest, no cheating. 5 seconds. 3, 2, 1, go. I don't care how many you get done. If it's 3, make them your best. If you're going for a number, stay consistent now. Keep it moving. We've just met the halfway mark. I keep bumping my microphone up to my back. Oh well. 10. Yeah. 3, 2, time. I feel like burpees with a microphone. Plank. We have a new variation if you'll follow. If you like one of the others we did, go back. It'll challenge your lats and your shoulder health. Forearm plank. 4, 3, 2. Hold it. Bring your toes together. With me. Right hip dip. Left hip dip. And then we hit a shift forward and back. At your own tempo. Little tiny dip on the hip. Shift forward and back. It's a very small movement. It should feel intense, but not painful. Get the neck nice and long. 10 seconds. We get recovery. Three, two, time. Excellent. All right. One more time. One more time. She's like, uh-uh. I'm gonna make you do one more time at home. Who's in? You and you, yep. You do not have to stay. If you have to go, you clean off your equipment, you go stretch and hydrate. If you want to stay for one more, it's the same thing. There's no surprises there. Grab water. 30 seconds, friends. You guys, we go for squats. Air squats right now feel kind of nice, so I'm sticking to what I know. That's just how it's gonna go down. I don't want to face you guys. Less than 10. Let's get after it. 3, 2, let's roll. Last round. Squat position. Best you can get me right here and right now. This is our finisher of our high intensity finisher. Weight is in the heels, hips are sinking nice and low. Even when the quads start to fire up, stay in it. Maybe don't come to a full stand. 15 seconds, you go. No more squats after this. See you next time. 3, 2, and time. Biceps curls coming up. Get your mat if you need it. Depending on your floor, this multi-purpose floor is killer on the knees. 5 seconds, get in position. Ready, set, curl. Keep the elbows tight, shoulders down. Small range of motion. Crown of the head is tall. Over halfway. Lock your hips in tight here. You have 10 more seconds. Nice modifications, friends. 3, 2, time. All right, friends, put those away. Snatching, alternating. One dumbbell. Big Alley, New York City. You are now locked the best. 5 seconds. 3, 2, let's go. I just did a traveling alternating snatch. Trying to get the camera view. Halfway. Quality over quantity now. Ten seconds. Four, three, two, time. Alternating lunge. Four movements left. That's all we got. Just four. Put your feet down. Grab your dumbbell. Front racket. Ready. Set. Go. Doesn't have to be a big step. Sink it down into the legs. Use your exhale in your core, the power in your standing, to overhead press. Halfway. Oh. Last 3, 2, time. Ten seconds. At the five, we pick up our dumbbell. Here we go. Front rack. 4, 3, 2, let's go. With control. You got to have a little determination to do thrusters and burpees, especially back to back. Keep that front rack tight. 12 seconds. We face burpees. Three, two, time. Burpees are coming. Seconds. You choose the variation, make them tough. Three, two, go. Higher jumps. Look straight forward. Halfway. Last 10. Three, two, time. Plank. It's our last move of the day. And it's a done class. 30-ish minutes, not bad. Hey, it's not 46. 5 seconds, you choose your plank. Out of any I've given you, 2, 1, go. If you'd like, you can mix it up. I'll give you the 10-second markers. Try all of them. You don't remember, we walked the plank, it's 10. There's 20. Toes together. Dip the hips. Forward and back. Last 10, you choose. This is it, friends. We recover after this. Three, two, time. You get a minute and 20. Take it. Take advantage. I'm going to stay with you for this recovery. Then I'm going to stop the recording and say hello to you that are on virtual. I hope you had a little fun today. That was a lot of repetition, a lot of opportunity to burn out and fatigue, which was our goal. We had in-person people, but they couldn't stay late. So I'm left all by myself. Except for you at home. We've been doing this at home a long time. I appreciate you all. You have another 35. Now that the heart rate might be coming down, do me a favor, take an inhale through the nose. Open your mouth and exhale. Yeah. Keep doing that. While you're taking your breath in and out, again, thank you for joining me for Quick Fix. It's always a pleasure to serve you guys, whether you're in person or virtual. We do have other in-person and virtual classes still happening here, although they're reduced size classes. If you haven't tried them, come in. We miss you. It's Monday. You got a lot of class options tomorrow. I hope I get to see you at the Dulc soon, whether it's virtual or in person. If you have questions or need anything, I'm going to hit stop on the record. I'll be available. Have a great afternoon, you guys. Thank you. Go there!